Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at the Unarchiver. So it's pretty easy to compress files and decompress them in Mac OS X. Refer to MacMost episodes 167 and 517. But what happens if you get a file that isn't a standard format like .zip or something and you need to decompress it? Well, there's a pretty standard utility that Mac users have been going to for years. It's called the Unarchiver and it's available in the Mac App Store for free. So you can find it pretty easily just by searching for it in the Mac App Store and then you can download it and add it to your apps. Once you have it installed, you can launch it pretty easily. And the first time you launch it, it's going to give you this big list of archive formats. And you select which ones you want. And it will recognize then that these file formats will be opened by Unarchiver on your Mac. And you can see that the list is pretty large, much larger than would be opened by the regular archive utility. That's why you really want this here, is in case you have one of these files. For instance, RAR archives are something you may find from time to time on the internet and it's very difficult to open them, but you can do that with this. And there's all sorts of other formats here. For me, a big one is StuffIt. StuffIt was very popular in the 90s for Mac users, so I've got a lot of stuff archived in .sit files, and being able to open them up using a utility here and not having to get the most recent version of StuffIt on all my Macs is very useful. So having all these file types and then you can have extraction preferences and even advanced preferences in here, so you can set that all up. Then I've got some files right here, an HQX compressed file and an RAR file, and you can see how to go about opening them. You just run Unarchiver and you can select one of the Unarchive options. Let's just do the Command O standard open. On the desktop I'll select one of these files, Unarchive, and you can see here it opened this up, which is an archive that contains a font. Likewise, the RAR file here, I can open that up as well. And you can see there it put the PDF file that came out of that. If you're looking for something more powerful, for only $4 you can get from the same developer the Archive Browser, which not only allows you to extract them but also be able to look inside of these archived files to find out what's in there and preview the contents. So very useful, especially if you've ever dealt with a file that you couldn't decompress using the standard archive utility built into your Mac, or you have old archives like I do in different formats. This is a great way to be able to get access to them without having to buy some software. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. And go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.